I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
All eyes are on Atlanta this Thursday as the earliest presidential debate in modern U.S. history is set to happen between the two oldest candidates ever to seek the country's highest office. President Joe Biden will face off with his Republican rival, former President Donald Trump, at 9 p.m. Eastern Time on June 27th. In a debate that will include two commercial breaks, no props, and muted microphones when the other candidate is speaking. And ahead of this historic debate, a New York Times Siena College poll released Wednesday found that Trump has a 4-point edge over Biden, polling it at 48% among likely voters and Biden at 44%. 77% of respondents said they intended to watch the debate and 19% said they would not. Fundraising numbers are also gaining traction for Trump despite his May conviction. At the end of that month, his campaign had $116 million in the bank compared to Biden's $91.6 million. Let's take a look at where both candidates stand on two key issues likely to be discussed at Thursday's presidential debate. On the issue of the economy, Biden has unveiled a plan to impose higher taxes on big and rich corporations and to bring back the child tax credit that expired in 2022. Trump, on the other hand, wants to extend his signature tax cuts that are slated to end next year. He also proposes to lower the corporate tax rate from the current 21%. When it comes to managing the economy, Biden has an edge when it comes to job growth, posting an additional 15.5 million jobs under his leadership compared to 5.2 million under Trump before the pandemic. But under Biden, inflation rose to around 5.5% compared to Trump averaging 1.9% during the pandemic and 2.1% pre-COVID. On the issue of immigration under Biden, the yearly average of migrants crossing the border has more than quadrupled compared to that of the Trump administration, with 6.4 million encounters outside official ports of entry along the southern border, according to the U.S. Customs and Border Patrol data. Amid attacks that he's too soft on immigration, Biden recently passed an executive order that bars migrants from being granted asylum when U.S. officials deem the southern border to be overwhelmed. His administration announced that border encounters with migrants are down 40% 3 weeks after Biden's order. Trump, on the other hand, has suggested deporting millions of undocumented immigrants if he wins a second term. From politics to sports, in Los Angeles, some honors for a pair of Filipina UCLA gymnasts. Filipina-American Emma Malabuyo and Filipina-Canadian Brooklyn Moores were named to the 2024 College Sports Communicators Academic All-District at-large teams, which recognize the nation's top student athletes for their athletic and academic performances. Moores, a junior, represented Canada in the 2020 Games and was this year's winner of the UCLA Athletic Director's Academic Excellence Awards. Meanwhile, this is the second academic all-district honor for Malabuyo. The college junior is headed to the Olympic Games in Paris to represent the Philippines. Both gymnasts are also considered finalists to be CSC Academic All-Americans.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Stay with us, Kapamilya.